tonight, the police commissioner orders a full investigation into claims of corruption on the Gold Coast.
Whistleblower detectives tell how a campaign of intimidation was waged against them.
They had to shut me up. I then decided that it was time to speak out.
Hail damage from wild storms across the southeast.
And a former nurse admits to running down and killing two Gold Coast students.
This is 7 News with Rod Young and Kay McGrath.
Good evening. The police commissioner has ordered a wide-ranging investigation into claims of corruption revealed by 7 News. He says all search warrants issued by Gold Coast detectives may be audited after allegations hundreds were based on falsified evidence to boost police statistics. And law-abiding citizens who believe they were illegally raided are now coming forward.
Bob Atkinson says he's determined to find out the truth.
They are very serious allegations. They strike at the heart of the professionalism and integrity of the Queensland Police Service.
Last night, 7 News revealed claims by detectives. Hundreds of search warrants on the Gold Coast were based on falsified evidence, and senior police knew and encouraged it.
In the program that was aired last night, for the first time in my understanding of this, there were some specific claims.
The Police Ethical Standards Command has been investigating for more than a year, but they haven't even interviewed all of the officers named in the complaint documents.
If there's been any delay in investigating something this serious, then I would be very concerned about that.
The commissioner says the investigation has been blocked by a whistleblower detective who won't be interviewed.
The officer concerned is currently facing criminal charges. They are unproven. He is entitled to the assumption of innocence.
The detective says he is facing charges of stalking a neighbour laid after he spoke out about the illegal warrants. He says he wouldn't be interviewed because the investigating officer is close friends with the senior Gold Coast police that are accused of running the dodgy warrant racket.
If that's the only barrier to his talking to us, we'll get someone completely fresh to do that.
He has now agreed to be interviewed, but still, the commissioner says more specific evidence is needed.
I would hope that if someone's home was searched by the police, and clearly, you know, there was no reason for that at all, that they would complain. I mean, they should complain.
The Appleby family did.
We couldn't see any logical legal reason for it being carried out, so it just seemed to be that that must have been why our name was drawn out of the hat, so we had a raid.
Their Helensvale home was raided more than 2 years ago. Police found nothing. They don't know whether the warrant was illegal, because police still won't give them a copy, despite repeated requests in writing and on the phone.
I sort of get the feeling that they were stonewalling us. They just wanted us to go away.
74-year-old Labrador man Ian Webster was raided too. Police asked for the retired radiographer's credit cards and to check his car. He doesn't have either.
It's a bit like a comedy act, you know. I went to the police station just to ask what happened and all that. And they just said, oh, if there's anything wrong, you'd have heard.
The commissioner says all warrants issued by Gold Coast Police may now be audited.
The allegations may yet be referred back to the CMC. It can force police to answer questions in secret hearings.
We can never say to you that we're over police corruption. We want people to be professional, to be ethical, to be honest.
Michael Best, 7 News.
Whistleblower detectives say many police opposed to carrying out raids based on illegal warrants were subjected to a campaign of intimidation. Some left the Gold Coast region to escape sustained harassment.
Buck the system and there was hell to pay, say the police officers who have made these allegations public.
I was the last one and I had started to become more vocal. They had to shut me up. I then decided that it was time to speak out.
In April, 7 News made a Freedom of Information application for police documents relating to up to 15 officers who allegedly moved from the Gold Coast region because they were opposed to the way some warrants were being issued. A number of them claimed they'd been harassed.
Once a person raises this issue with, or had raised this issue with, senior management, those people were then targeted.
Police refused the FOI request on the grounds it could prejudice any investigation.
I don't think a smear campaign is a useful response to these types of allegations.
If that is ever established against any police manager anywhere in the state, I say this to you, that person will be removed from their position.
One whistleblower also says the alleged illegal warrant racket was affecting the fight against real crime.
Major crime is pushed aside to to obtain arrest figures and numbers in relation to numbers of search warrants, etc., etc.
When 7 News first revealed the allegations of illegal warrants yesterday, police media attacked them, describing them as nebulous in a statement and in a phone conversation called us ludicrous for raising the issue. But now the Commissioner is taking them seriously.
We will investigate everything thoroughly and fully.
Neil Warren, 7 News.
Premier Anna Bligh says she'll stop police using justices of the peace to sign search warrants if the CMC recommends it. JPs are meant to ensure officers don't abuse their power and carry out illegal raids.
Before detectives conduct a raid, they need a search warrant stamped by a magistrate or justice of the peace. Many prefer to go to a JP. On the Gold Coast, officers regularly knock on Anthea Blake's door.
They convince me, and I can convince myself with what is put on that warrant.
Some weeks, Anthea authorises a large number of warrants.
All of a sudden, I might do, say, 10, 15, maybe 20.
JPs are allowed to ask probing questions, but not when it comes to tip-offs from informants about suspected drug use. And that's been the subject of many of the alleged dodgy raids.
Drug warrants are very tricky. You can rely on what the police tell you.
There's no suggestion that any of Queensland's 26,887 JPs qualified to sign warrants have done anything wrong. The issue is whether police have taken advantage of their good nature and lack of extensive legal training.
In New South Wales, the government has banned JPs signing warrants because of fears about police dishonesty. Solicitor Glenn Milne is representing 4 detectives who've blown the whistle over the dodgy document scandal. The Vietnam veteran and former RSL president believes JPs should no longer be signing warrants.
These matters ought properly be dealt with by judges and or magistrates.
If the CMC believed that as a result of this investigation there were any systemic problems that warranted further consideration by government, then I'd certainly support them having a look into that.
Peter Doherty, 7 News.
Since 7 News broke the story last night, we've received dozens of calls and emails relating to raids and the alleged illegal use of police warrants. If you have information you believe needs to be investigated, email us at 7news@7.com.au.